What is up, guys? Today I'm going to make a spiral lanyard for you guys, a round crown. It has a lot of names. Those should be in the description because you found this video. And it looks like this. For this project, you will need paracord. You have here urban camo, gecko, safety orange, and blue camo. For this project, I will be using the gecko and some black. You'll need a knife or scissors. This is a Swiss Army knife, genuine one. This one is the Tinker Deluxe and it has the scissors and the knife. Choose the one that works best for you. I'll be choosing the scissors because they are sharp and I can cut it when I need it in the place that I need it without imperfections. So this will give me the best results. After that, you need a lighter to burn the ends of the paracord. Of course, you can use other types of cordage, but paracord is the best. Making a lanyard for your knife is extremely useful. It helps take your knife out of your pocket and in an emergency situation. For example, these paracord braces, you carry them because they carry a lot of rope and you carry them in your wrists without bothering you. So when you need rope, you have it. In any emergency situation, in a survival situation, or in your everyday necessity, if you need a rope, you have it in your wrist. The same way the lanyard works, the same way you carry rope with it. And to make this lanyard, you need to know that the 3 inches, which is 7 centimeters paracord, to make the lanyard, you will need 2 times 3 feet, which is the two colors, black and the green. So 2 times 3 feet, which is the same thing as 2 times 30 centimeters. That's what we need to do this project. We have all of our tools, the paracord cuts to the length that I want. Don't forget to use a ruler to check the measurements. What you need to do right now to start this is to choose what color will be the loop behind. I want the black to be part of the loop that will allow my lanyard to be attached to this knife, for example. Let's start. Remember, I want the black to be the loop. So my loop color, the loop that supports the lanyard, I want it to be the black. So remember, the black, find that the middle point, which is here. The black needs to be the horizontal one and under the green. Now find the middle point. If it's not perfect, it's okay, guys. The middle point right there, and lay that on top. Now follow me. Grab the right side, put it to the left. Grab the left, put it to the right, like this. Make this shape, just like this. The top part needs to go over this one in the hole. Same thing with the bottom. Goes over this one in that hole right there. Now just tie everything. Not too much, guys. This is very important. Because once you get this part done, it should be easy. This is the worst. It's the start. Once you're happy with that, don't over tie it. See, looks really nice right now. As you can see here in the back, the black is on top, so that will be our loop as I planned. That's very important. Do the same thing. The left goes to the right goes to the left. So this, the bottom one needs to go over in like this, and this one goes over in and tie it again. Don't over tie it because we want to do the loop. Just give it the basic shape. This one will be really, really beautiful, guys. These colors are awesome. Turn everything around and As you can see, the top one is the black, that will be our loop. Just pull it until you're happy with the size. This one should be enough for me. Now you can tie it to 100%. This first knot won't be for perfect, guys, because you have the loop. You can do this without the loop, but wait, you have the loop already, so it's just one thing that you won't have to do later. Now that we have our loop made, we have a square knot right here. Previously I told you guys how to do the square knot. We will stop that because we're going to start with the round one, which is called the round lanyard. Some people call it the spiral lanyard. And to do this, you grab the right piece to the left where it goes behind this one. As you can see, behind. The same thing, the right one goes to the left, the left goes to the right one goes to the left behind this one. As you guys clearly can see, try to do this shape because it helps. Grab the top part and needs to go over this one in that hole. The same thing happens with this one, needs to go over this one in that hole. Now just pull everything and tie it. It's still a square knot, guys, but as you can see, it's starting to rotate, and that's what we want. Always do the same thing. The right side goes to the left behind the left piece of black paracord. This, the left one goes to the right behind that piece of paracord, like this. Again, try to keep a shape like this. Like this, because it helps a bit. You feed this in the loop that's the farthest away from you, as you can see clearly, is this one. It needs to go over and in. The same thing, this one is the farthest loop, goes over and in. Pull the black like this, it's easier. Tie everything. Clearly the lanyard is starting to turn. As you can see, you're starting to get that round shape, that curve, that spiral. Let's keep on doing. The left goes to the right behind the right piece. The right goes to the left behind the left piece. You feed the top part in the farthest loop, which is here. Do the same thing with the bottom piece. Tie it. Pull, pull, and we have another square knot with a turn. One last time before I finish this, the right piece goes to the left piece, goes to the right behind the right piece. The right piece goes to the left behind that left piece in the corner, like that. That's what gives us our turn. Fit the top part in the farthest loop, which is this one. This one is the more away loop. This is too close, and this is the second. So fit that through there. Pull the black. Tie everything. I'll keep doing this, guys, until I finish and show you guys the final result. Hope you guys like it. And here's the final result, guys. As you can see, clearly the spiral with the black and the gecko color. Now what's missing is to trim those tips and burn them, and this is ready to go to your keys, to your knives, yeah, that's it guys. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope this helps you, because it can be sometimes frustrating to do this at the first time. It's a bit annoying. And don't forget to give me a thumbs up if this helps you, or even add this to your favorites, or even share it with your friends, someone that would probably like to do this. Add it to your favorites to try to do it later. Yeah, that's it guys. I hope you guys like it, and I hope you guys have a great day. Take care.